much for being here in this summer siesta time. I hope don't bore you too much. Well, I am going to talk about of an ongoing archaeoastronomical study of Iberian Iron Age sanctuaries. I have studied different kinds of sanctuaries, open air sanctuaries, temples, but in this moment I will concentrate on the results about caves. Well, first of all, I am an astronomer, almost all my works have been done in collaboration of archaeologists, so you can to be not too much suspicious of the study. In previous talks, Iberian culture has been defined. But we are talking about culture in this part of Spain, in the Mediterranean facet of Spain, that developed in the last half of the first millennium BC and ended with the Roman invasion of Spain at about 200 BC. Along many years I have been studying sanctuaries, Iberian sanctuaries, and also Tartessian and previous ones, the sanctuaries in the south, and this is more or less the inventory of places that I have study. Only seven of them are cave sanctuaries, so the results are not still statistically significant. Okay. Well, I will talk you about the results, the general results, the main results that I have found in open air and temples of the Iberian culture. When I study a site, I measure the orientation of the buildings, of the remains, but also I measure the horizon with the purpose of see the relation of the building or of the sanctuary with the astronomical context, in the sense of where the rising of the celestial bodies or their setting occurs. In relation with the orientation of the temples, I have found that most of them are oriented to the east. Here we can see the 360 degrees of the horizon, and each line represents one temple. They are oriented mostly to the east. You can see several crazy orientations, no? But most of them, I have to say that most of them correspond to second entrances, to buildings that have two entrances, and one of them is oriented to the general custom, to be oriented to this, and the other one is oriented to the perpendicular. Okay? This area corresponds to the arc of the horizon where the sunrises take place. No? The sunrise cannot take place at any point of the horizon, no? As you know, it's restricted to an area. This represents that area. We can compare with the orientation patterns of temples of contemporary cultures in the Western Mediterranean. We can see that Roman temples are normally oriented in a random form. Their orientation. The Etruscans have a special orientation to the south half. The Greek also is quite random, but concentrated to the east. But we can see here Greek temples in the Magna Graecia and Sicily that are also concentrated to the east. Also Punic temples from North Africa. And this is very interesting because the Roman temples dedicated to Saturn in North Africa are also orientated to the same pattern. What's the meaning of this? This is because in North Africa, the Roman temples dedicated to Saturn are normally previous Punic temples dedicated to Baal Hamon. Well, you can see that the Iberian custom of orientation is similar to this one. With respect to the horizon that surrounds the Iberian temples, I have found a very striking result, that is that almost half of them show equinoctial markers in their horizon. What does it mean? This is that the sunrise at the equinox, or at the very close to the equinox, is produced to a singular point of the horizon. Normally, a mountain peak, for example. Here we can see a very striking place. This is this is the remains, the very few remains of a wall of an Iberian sanctuary that is in a hill just on the coast. You can see one of the walls that remain that is oriented to this isle. This is the Isle of Benidorm. Many of you will know that. And if you are there at the sanctuary in the morning of the equinox, you will see that the sun rises just at that height. Okay? This is very striking, and you can see also this marker and also the orientation of the temple. There are several other very striking cases, just this one in El Amarejo, where the sun of the equinox makes its apparition here and is escalating in the south slope of the mountain, just only in the equinox. These are other cases. You can see orientation of walls in sacred spaces and equinox taking place in mountains, in the top of mountains. Well, and what about the caves? Caves, as I said before, I have only studied 7 caves, okay? 2 of them do not show, at least for me, any astronomical relation, but 5 of them, yes. 3 of them are caves which are deeper than the size of their entrance, so they can be considered caves, and the other 2 are rocky shelters that are not deep. The caves have, these 3 caves show striking solar illumination phenomenon, as we will see, and the rocky shelters have similarities with the open air Iberian sanctuaries because they show astronomical markers in the horizon. Yes, this is the first one that I studied with Carmen. It's in La Cueva de la Noguera, one important Iberian sanctuary. We can see that there is an entrance at the north. And this is very important because this is the so-called the western window of the cave. And there are indications that the shape of this window was manipulated in the past. Okay? Was altered by handmade. Yes, the important thing here, important astronomical thing here, is that just at the moment of the sunset, when the sun is reaching the horizon at the equinoxes, the patch of light projected by the western window touches the innermost part of the cave. That coincides with a slot or hole, more or less, this size. Producing a particular shape in the patch of light that we can discuss about that, but this is not the time. This is only produced at equinox. Eh? We can see that the patch of light is red, and well, this is a very rapid, quite rapid phenomenon, and we understand it as a hierophany, because it might be related with a dramatization of the ritual. We told about that in the paper. Okay, this is another example. This is, I called it Cueva de la Nariz, but Susana told it Umbria de Salchita. Eh? Well, we have some problems of name. Well, this cave is very spectacular because it has two main galleries, like the galleries of the nose, no? The holes of the nose. There are two parallel galleries of the same depth. When we visited it, we noticed that at least the northern gallery the main axis, that is almost 20 meters long or more, I don't remember exactly. The gallery is oriented to the sunset at the winter solstice, very precisely. We were there at the moment of the sunset, of the local sunset at that particular moment of the year, and we can see from the innermost part of the cave, you can see that the sun is setting perfectly at the middle of the aperture. In this point, in the innermost part of the cave, you can see this. There is a rock basin that is normally collects the water for water spring that is in the interior of the cave, and it has been manipulated. No, you can see here an artificial canal, probably a manipulated basin that collects the water. Just at the last sun rays of the day, of the winter solstice, you can see during a few seconds, perhaps a minute, you can see tangential rays illuminating the surface of the water. This is, you can understand that this is it gives a lot that it seems that to be a dramatization or something, no? It's something that could be very full of senses or full of information for the people seeing this. A third example is in Cueva Santa del Cabriel. This is the last one that I have studied with Sonia. And this is very spectacular also because this is still a place of worship. It's a Catholic sanctuary dedicated to the Virgin Mary, but it was used as Iberian sanctuary, and also perhaps it was used even before in the Chalcolithic and the Bronze Age. The main point of this is that the main entrance of the cave is the 12 meter long corridor is oriented perfectly to the summer solstice sunset. You can see here a very tiny part of the horizon. This is the photographs of the illumination of the main gallery from the with the sun entering from the through the horizon, and the last slides will be dedicated to the rocky shelters. The rocky shelters, I have to say, that they show astronomical markers similar to the open air sanctuaries, as in the case of Cueva del Rey Moro, that we find equinoctial and solstitial markers in the horizon. And especially here in Cueva Negra, in Fortuna, Murcia, we have found, well, the shelter is oriented to the south, but we can see here a very particular mountain. And if we measure the mountain, we can find that the sunrise at 27 miles should take place over that peak, the mountain. But this cave sanctuary in Roman times, was plenty of inscriptions, painted inscriptions, and in three of them, the only day that is indicated in the inscriptions is Sex Calendas Apriles. It would correspond perfectly with 27 March if they were painted, if the inscriptions were painted in the 3rd century AD, which is a result which is in is consistent with the stylistic chronology of the inscriptions. This is a quite interesting result. Okay, and that's my last slide. Well, all the results indicate the importance of the solstices and equinox in the Iberian ritual. They should have at least a concept of quadriposition of the year, at least. And many or several rituals were related with this important part of the solar calendar. The caves tend to be oriented to the west. This is in contrast with the normal custom of the sun open air and temple sanctuaries that are oriented to the east. In the caves, there are evidences of manipulation of elements, perhaps for the dramatization of the ritual, of the phenomena of light and shadow inside the cave. Also, the small size of the caves indicate that this phenomenon, this performances were restricted only for a few number of people, a small number of people, restricted perhaps to ritual or passages or something like that. And sanctuaries in rocky shelters show astronomical markers in a similar way than open air sanctuaries. And then it seems that rocky shelters and caves should have differences in the ritual. This is something that we should study in the future. Thank you very much. Okay.